Hey guys, welcome back. Hey guys, welcome to my channel. Welcome back to my channel. My name is Caroline Prokos. All the good girls go to hell. And today I'm actually doing a video that I've been super excited about. I'm rating my favorite coffee shops in Columbus, Ohio. That's where I'm from. I'm a sophomore at NYU and I'm home for break. There are like 3 or 4 coffee shops in Ohio that I regularly go to, and I just wanted to like go to all of them. This might be Hello. I knew that would fucking happen. I'm gonna rate them on, actually I didn't even look that up. I'm freaking dumb. Okay, so I'm going to therapy right now, but once I get back, we're just gonna go straight to Fox in the Snow and let's get on to the video. Okay, hey guys, so I'm at the coffee shop and it's called Fox in the Snow and it's in New Albany, Ohio. And I used to come here all the time with my friends. So basically I'm going to review the coffee shop based on 3 criteria. The first one being what I order, the quality of the food and the menu items, and like the diversity of the menu, if they have food, stuff like that. The atmosphere, so like how crowded it is, the seating, the music, if they have any, do they have Wi-Fi, and just like ability to get work done, or like if you want to come here and study or do homework or whatever. Thirdly, just like the overall, everything together, like the location, the atmosphere, the menu. See you guys in there. Okay, let's go. So basically, there's like a huge parking lot in the back. I'm actually going at kind of an off hour. It's 3 o'clock and it closes at 5. So hopefully like not a lot of people will be here so I can vlog and I don't get nervous, vlog anxiety. I used to not like it here because they didn't have like Splenda and they only had like naturals. So we all know I love my Splenda. I just got cold milk. Cute bathroom. That's a plus. Now I'm gonna tell you guys my thoughts. I would have talked more in there, but it's just kind of awkward. Also, there was someone in there from my high school and I was like, the first criteria that we are discussing would be menu and the quality of the drinks. Actually, Fox in the Snow has a lot of really good food. They mostly have baked goods, which I like filmed a lot of. They have like donuts and they have popovers and they have breads like banana bread, pound cake, an iced cinnamon bun thing, which is really good. And they also have like hot food, so they have like breakfast sandwiches, bacon, egg and cheese, oatmeal. But I would say their food overall is like really good. I didn't get food this time because I'm not that hungry. It's a good like breakfast item or even lunch. My drink was amazing. I just kind of got into cappuccinos, honestly. I used to get lattes a lot, but I think I just like the frothiness of the cap. They do have a milk alternative and I got it with oat milk, as I said, and it was really good, really tasty. The coffee was really smooth, put a lot of Splenda in it so it wasn't too bitter, and it was a good size. I forget how, I think it was like $4.20 or something. $4 to $5 for Ohio and like for this type of coffee shop. Perfectly appropriate to pricing. The only thing is they don't have like flavoring, so you can't get like caramel or like mocha or anything, but I feel like that's more like streamlined for them. The second thing I'm going to talk about is the atmosphere and the seating. I really like this shop. It's a little bit more modern. It's all wood and like very clean surfaces. There's a lot of seating, but when it gets really crowded, especially on the weekends, it can get kind of loud in there just because the sound kind of echoes off the walls. And the music was just like typical coffee house music. It wasn't too loud, so you weren't like screaming, but you could still hear it. I think you could definitely do work in there. It just depends when you go. As I said, like I just went at 3 o'clock and it closes at 5, so there weren't a lot of people in there and I definitely could have gotten some work done. A few people had their laptops out. I don't think they have Wi-Fi actually, so maybe it's good for like writing an essay or editing or just reading or whatever. Yeah. There's also outdoor seating for like the warmer months. It's also just a good place to like catch up with your friends. Even have like a business meeting, good first date place. I used to go on dates there all the time. Yeah, I think it's just like good for all events. The only thing is if you're like meeting up with a lot of different people, there might not be enough seats, but there are longer tables in there that like you can sit more people, but the tables are a little bit wide. So you kind of have to raise your voice a little bit to get the other person to hear you. And then the third thing is just kind of like what makes it unique, what I liked about it, what I don't like about it. So what I like about Fox in the Snow is, well, I'm a little biased. I just really like this area. I went to school around here, so it kind of just feels like comfortable to me. I just really like the vibe in there. It's calm. You don't feel like rushed. It's not like chaotic atmosphere, which like most coffee shops aren't. But I feel like some of them are very like, oh, we do very important work here. Blah, blah, and you can only get black coffee. Do you? And very chill vibes. I like the food and stuff. What I don't like about it, it doesn't have Wi-Fi, so that's kind of like a big downer if you're really going to do work. But as I said, this isn't the first place that comes to mind when I think of like studying or doing work. Yeah, that's really it. So we're gonna go to the next coffee shop now. Actually, I'm going to the mall right now to go to Lululemon. But after that, we will go to the next coffee shop. Peace. Alright, so I have come back from the mall and wait, can I just show you what I got? Literally, I have to censor myself so much. Censor is not the right word, like for sure, but I could buy the whole freaking store at Lululemon. So I just got this tee, size 6, just the black long sleeve. They had so many cute colors, but I don't know. I feel like I just wanted black because it's easy and like you can't see my fat rolls, so just kidding. So now I am in Grandview, Ohio, which is another really nice part of Ohio, Columbus. I'm going to a coffee shop called Stoff's. And so we're just doing the same three criteria. We're doing the quality of the food, which I don't, they stopped serving food at 3, I believe, but the quality of the food and the drink, and then the atmosphere, and then just like overall, and I'll also show like seating and stuff. Okay, see you in there. When I left, I got just a coffee to go. Honestly, I'm gonna be like completely real with you guys here. I know nothing about coffee. Yeah, definitely know there's like different roasts, different caffeine levels, whatever. I mean, all coffee kind of tastes the same to me. Their coffee is fine for me. Honestly, I don't get a lot of caffeine from it, but it gives me a good boost. So as far as their menu goes and their drinks and stuff, Stoff's has like a lot of specialty stuff. They have like all the flavors you could possibly think of, plus sugar-free, so that's definitely a plus. And they have like specialty drinks like an Almond Joy, which is like coconut syrup, almond milk. You can get like hot or iced, and Buckeye thing, which is like peanut buttery and chocolate. And they always have seasonal drinks like gingerbread during the holidays and like eggnog. What did they have for Halloween? I don't know. It's always like super creative. Everything tastes really good. And they also have smoothies and they have tea. I would say their menu drink wise is definitely a lot more of a range than Fox in the Snow. They do get their beans from like very specific places. Also, it's also a roaster, so you can like buy beans there, which you guys saw like the bins of all the coffee beans and stuff. I would say it's more intense of a coffee place than like Fox in the Snow. And then their food, the kitchen closes at 3 and they're open till 10. The quality of the food's okay. I've had a bacon, egg, and cheese there, which is really good. I got on a bagel, and then I've gotten avocado toast. It's kind of just like really minimal though. $6 or $7 for avocado toast, and you literally get like one piece of toast with like some avocado spread on it and like an egg. So it just depends what you get. I've also gotten like a salad there that was pretty good. It's not the best food. I don't go there for the food. I don't think a lot of people do, but they do have like good bagels. I mean, how can you really mess up bagels? They have all the different flavored cream cheeses, and they also have like muffins and pie and cake, energy bars, cookies, chips, stuff like that. As far as atmosphere goes, so seating. So when I got in there, there are no seats. And that's like honestly pretty rare for Stoff's, I feel like. I've only ever seen that on the weekend. And it was weird because it was like 5 o'clock and usually I feel like there's seats. So that was one thing that was kind of disappointing, but it's usually not like that. The seating's usually pretty good. I've never really had an issue with it. And then obviously in the summer months, the outdoor patio opens up, which I also showed. And that's really nice on summer nights when it's not too hot, not too buggy. Also, it's really nice when it's raining because it's covered. So it's like you can kind of hear the rain and like relax out there. So I do that a lot in the summer. And then parking is great. Well, it depends. So if you're here during the week, it's usually fine. There's a big parking lot behind Stoff's, and there's also like metered parking and free spaces, I believe, down Grandview Avenue. But if you come on like a Friday night, Saturday night, and sometimes even a Thursday night, the back parking lot will be filled because everyone's going to dinner, because there's a lot of really good restaurants in Grandview. But there is a parking lot that's like way down, it's not way down, but down Grandview Avenue a little bit. But I feel like you can always find a spot. The most I've had to be looking for a spot is probably like
10 to 15 minutes. And then stuff is usually like not that crowded on like Friday night, Saturday night, obviously, because like people go out. Sunday night, surprisingly pretty crowded, just because it's like before the week starts. People like to get their shit done. Other things about stuff. So if you guys could tell, it was like pretty homey. It's carpeted. It's just kind of like more, I would say like more chill than Fox in the Snow or like a lot of other coffee shops in Columbus. And if you've been watching me for a while, you know that this is like my go-to coffee shop. I love the vibe that Stoff's has. It's very not so modern. It's definitely more cozy. All they're really missing is like a fireplace, and that'd be legit. Actually, I think there's one in there. It's just not on. It's a little bit grimy, not perfectly modern and wooden and clean and white. It's very just like, it's where the locals come. I started going here a couple years ago. It's really gotten popular since then, and they've opened up a lot of other locations in Columbus. The staff are pretty nice. Some of them are like kind of bitchy, but it's fine. The lighting's like nice and low. Usually really good music, and it's at like a nice volume, and it's definitely good for doing work. That's usually mainly why I go there. And they have Wi-Fi. It's not great for hard focus, like deep focus work, but you could like write a paper there. I've done that. I edit all my shit while I'm there. Definitely good for like meeting up with friends. Even like a larger group of friends, I would say, is pretty safe. And I just love the location.
The next day.
Okay, hello folks, it is the next day. I am ready to rumble. Day two of this coffee shop extravaganza. I am going to a coffee shop that's actually closer to where I live. It's in Dublin, Ohio. It's a pretty new coffee shop. It's in like a newer development area. We're just gonna go on over there. It's called Sweetwater Cafe, I think. I think it's family owned. And I also think it's a franchise, but I'm not actually sure. It is so damn ass foggy out. I hope everyone had, well, you guys didn't sleep because this just happened in 1 second for you, but I slept grandly. We have arrived. Great, let's go. Got it to go, and I got a vanilla, what did I get? A double vanilla cappuccino with almond milk. I'm now thinking back on this video, and I probably should have gotten the same thing at all, but I guess we're not really testing the coffee. It's more just like an overview. So I haven't had it yet, so we're just gonna do a taste test. That's really good. Wow, that's good. Yeah, probably the best coffee like I've had. So quality of the menu and the food and stuff and the drink, I would say the menu has like a lot of tea. They have like frappuccinos, so it's more like Starbucks in that way. They have just more like diverse than like just coffee and tea. Smoothies, all different types of like Vietnamese, like au lait, different sweet creams and stuff like that. So they definitely have a wider way of like flavorings, and they had sugar-free syrups, and they had like all different types of milk as well. I'm like very pleasantly surprised. I had a donut from there once that was pretty good. I don't know if they have hot breakfast. I don't think they do. Yeah, they just have like pastries and little bars and stuff. And then they have like juices, like bottled tea and stuff. I have no complaints about it, and this is amazing. The atmosphere, I don't know, it's a little plain Jane for me. There's not much character to it. It is a newer place. It wasn't crowded at all. There's a lot of seating. They had like high tops, and they had some low tops, and they had couches. There's not really like a lot going on in there. It's just like pretty straightforward coffee. They could have used with like some artwork or something, but there was music, and it was a low, and there was Wi-Fi, and they had all different types of like sweeteners, which I really enjoy, because I feel like some coffee shops like try to be super like intense and elite and like not have fake sugar, and I know, love my Splenda. Glad they had all of that. It just like wasn't anything spectacular, anything extraordinary, like pretty average. So I'm just gonna say a 5. And then overall experience, pretty good. The staff is really nice. So overall experience, I'm gonna say it was good. This is so good. I think it's the vanilla. I usually don't get flavoring, but I'm gonna go home now. All right, it's been fun. It's been real. I might do another coffee shop, and I might not. I don't know. Hey
guys, so it's actually a lot later. I went to lunch with my friend, 3:10. I'm going to a coffee shop that I've never been to. I actually don't even know what it's called. If you are from Columbus, there's like in the short north down by like OSU campus. It's called, I literally couldn't even tell you, Poindexter Coffee. I've been meaning to go here. I don't know what it's gonna be like. Fuck, it's raining. I have an umbrella. As far as the location, it's in like the center of downtown Columbus, pretty close to campus, Ohio State campus. Parking is pretty minimal. There are a few lots around the short north, but like I did street parking. I hope I can park here. I don't even really know. Let's go on in and check it out. I'm kind of in the mood for a matcha, but I'm not really sure. We'll just see. So that was definitely interesting. It looked like an old, what are they called? Why can't I think of the word right now? Trailer. But it was very like diner-esque. The guy was kind of weird, but he was nice. There's only one other guy in there. There's like couches and pillows and like really cool like stool things looking at that you guys saw. I got a chai latte with, I wanted oat milk and he said that they ran out, but they guess they do have milk alternatives. Test this out. Oh, that's good. It tastes like, it's a little bit sweeter than the chai I've had before. It tastes like there's a hint of like gingerbread. It's really good, I like it. I didn't put any sweetener in it. I'm gonna give this drink like 10 out of 10, really good. Serves its purpose, does its job. I didn't look at the food, but it looked like it's open till 11 o'clock, breakfast, lunch, and dinner. I didn't look at the menu, but it had like a pastry case, but it was like not even halfway full. So maybe they like sold out a lot of it in the morning. After a certain time, they had alcohol. Hey guys, so I didn't think I did a very good job of like explaining what this place was kind of like, because honestly I didn't spend that much time in there. But basically it's like a cafe by day and then a bar by night. It's actually part of the new hotel that's in the short north called the Graduate Hotel. But I'm just on their website and I'm kind of just trying to look at their menu to give you like a better idea. Their menu says it includes locally inspired cocktails, wine and craft beer, laid back bites like avocado toast, all you can eat cereal, and pizza too. It looks like they do have a lot of different things and they're open from 6:30 a.m. to 11 p.m. I'm just looking more specifically at their menu. As far as like their coffee menu, they have like drip coffee, espresso, cordata, like everything cap, latte, mocha. They have breakfast, they have like all you can eat cereal, bacon, egg, and cheese, pizzas. Looks like they just have like cocktails, beer, and wine. So I didn't like think I gave it a very fair evaluation just because I wasn't there for that long and I really didn't like look at the menu. So there's some more information on Poindexter if you ever wanted to check it out. Happy watching. Don't know if I'd go there for dinner necessarily, but vibes could be cool if they like lowered the lighting. There's definitely a cool place. Don't know if I go back just because it's not like that close to me, and if I were to come down here to get coffee I'd probably go to Stoff's. You could definitely do work there. It was really quiet. I didn't notice any music. I feel like they did have it, I just like wasn't conscious of it really. And then aesthetically it was just pretty clean lines. I wouldn't say it was like modern or cozy like Stoff's. It was more just like a diner pretty much. They had Wi-Fi. You could honestly do anything. You can do work there, you could have a business meeting, you could meet friends. They had a lot of different seating. What else am I don't even know what else I'm supposed to be talking about. Oh, overall experience was good. My chai latte, I got the small, it was like $4.75. I'm currently driving, so I'm gonna go. I just realized I didn't end the video, so if you liked me, if you didn't like me, like and subscribe down below, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye y'all.